Suppose you have a task, a problem, that you would like to solve with a computer. You may ask yourself, is it possible to use a computer to solve this? What kind of computer do I need? The general goal of computational complexity is to give formal answers to these kind of questions. We would like to investigate what resources are required to solve some given problem. A common computational resource which is considered is time. How long does my computer need to run for to find a solution for this problem? Another resource of interest could be memory. How much memory do I need to solve this problem? Yet another, but maybe less obvious resource would be access to random numbers. If I have access to a source that provides me with random numbers, can I do things that I would be otherwise unable to do? What if you want to use more than a single computer to solve a problem? Say you have two computers who should work together. Then they probably need to communicate with one another. We may be interested in studying how much communication is required between the two computers. What capacity do we need for the data link connecting them? We would like to classify, to group together, problems according to the amount of resources that are roughly required to obtain a solution. This also involves relating different problems to one another. Sometimes such problems may already look very similar when we first encounter them. At other times, the deep connection between two different problems only reveals itself once we spend considerable effort studying them. The potential payoff, however, is significant. Suppose you have a new task, one you haven't encountered before. If you have enough experience, you may be able to judge to determine whether it is feasible to solve these tasks with a computer or whether that's not feasible. How much computational power and memory would you need for this task, for example? This could save valuable time. It is better to find out early on that what you are trying to do is impossible, instead of spending maybe months trying to write a program only to discover later on that you were doomed to fail from the start. On a more positive note, suppose the task that you're now getting is really new to you, but maybe you're already aware of a solution to some other task. With sufficient experience, you may be able to see that the new task and the old task that you already know are in fact related to one another. This can be true even when the relationship between them is far from obvious. Then you may be able to adopt the program for the old task to the new task rather than starting from scratch. This is a motivation to study computational complexity.